Okie dokie, everybody. Sort of strange, but today's thing is going to be a... Nope, just kidding. Yep, there we go. A origami hyperbolic plane. If you have seen me or know me really well, you know that I've made a bajillion of these things, and I'm gonna add a bunch of links today to today's thing, just because this is less like a super creative thing. Like, you can pick your paper, and maybe I would be thrilled if you guys came up with awesome ideas, but these are hyperbolic planes that Dina Taimina, I'm probably saying it the wrong, suggested, or like figured out how to crochet, and so I'm gonna show you how to make one. Yay! And this, by the way, I should say, this came about because of a fantastic student of mine who gave me this, literally this one, 4 years ago. And it has been sitting on my shelf ever since. I was overjoyed when it came around. So it's exciting. And you'll notice that actually these two are slightly different. So there is room to play. But I'm going to teach you how to make a kink one, because that's what I know how to do right now. And it's gonna be great. So you're gonna get a piece of paper. It can be a totally regular piece of paper. I do happen to have origami paper, and I'm gonna use that because it's super easy to for you guys to see when I'm on the white side versus on the front side. So the very first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna fold it into a triangle like this. Unfold it this way. It's totally worth your time to make nicer creases, because it will make your life easier later on. And then you're gonna fold it like this. Yay, so it's curving up like this. I'm gonna suggest that you flip it over to the other side. This will help. So it's kind of like making a little mountain-y type thing right here. Then we're gonna fold it horizontally like this. I think those are words that I can use reasonably, maybe. Unfold it. And then fold it again horizontally. Cool. And what's nice about this is that then it starts kind of popping like you'd like it to. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna push in here, so that it becomes this lovely little triangle with those flappy bits right there. Okay, so now we've got this, and we need to start making all of these lovely little lines here. So what we're gonna do is take this point and get it to match up over there. And then we're gonna go from here to here. My coffee maker in the background, in case you can hear that. And then we're gonna fold this line up parallel with this line. And I have yet to get it to be totally perfect when I do this, but it works kind of well. And then we're gonna divide these all equally in half as well to get a line here, here, and here. So this point up to this intersection. And then if you take this point and push it to this intersection, you'll cut the second one in half. Not cut, fold the second one in half. Then what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna get this line and this line to fold on each other, which means the second line down here, which I know is kind of hard for y'all to see, the second line down here, the curves and the, there we go. Second line down here is where my bottom line is going to fold up, that original triangle, and then this bottom is just going to come up to meet that very first parallel line. Okay, and what happens now is when you unfold it, you get all of these beautiful, lovely lines. This is where it gets a little picky, but it's not so bad. What you're going to do is this first section on the outside, you're gonna fold over right up until this diagonal line here. And things are gonna start kind of pinching strangely. So I'm gonna keep, and then I wanna do this all the way around the whole thing. So I'm gonna pinch, pinch, pinch. And you're gonna get this weird little flappy bit right here. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Same thing here. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Flappy bit. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Yeah. Okay. And then just like you might see here where we're getting these like little foldy things, what I really want to be doing is I want to take my original thing and I'm going to pinch, I'm going to kind of like accordion style, but only this triangle here. That's really what I want to end up doing. So my next job is I'm going to take this second line and then pinch that up as well, and then just work my way around. And I've noticed it will help if you just start thinking about these, the corners kind of pinching into straight lines here. That will help you kind of manage the folding. I hope you're all speeding the video up at this point. And then again, these two are gonna come together. And notice there's just gotta be a lot of forgiveness and kinda sorta ing it. The nice thing about paper, this is the whole idea behind origami, you guys, is that paper bends. It's foldy. And this is really relatively forgiving. Folding, it's bending, just keeping going with all this. We're getting closer to that kind of four-pointed star shape that you saw at the beginning. Give yourself some time. I have a decent feel for paper, but it's just paper, right? And if you tear it, like, who cares? It's get more paper. Well, I hope you have plenty of paper, but use notebook paper for this. Use whatever you want. And then, la voila. And then we're back kind of where I started at the beginning. And when you pull this out, notice it's going to kind of naturally do this lovely curving thing. And this is totally negatively curved space. Ooh, look at that. It's kind of a strange, strange beast. And then you have your very own hyperbolic origami, you guys. Yay! Take your pictures of yours, or videos, even better. Post it. I would love to see it. You're all fantastic. And I hope you are well.